So what's been going on? Well, we've got the ID back scenes mounted now on architectural board. This is the industrial pack A and B. This section here is pack B. And then the rest is pack A. Only took about an hour to glue these on the backboard because they are already self-adhesive. We've also got new additions. These two features, the fuel point and the porter cabin, they are from Manchester Models. Sorry, made in Manchester Models, to apologise. We've also done quite a lot of weathering using Vallejo powders mixed with PECO powders, and that's been plastered everywhere. It's not finished yet, there's still a bit to go, but most of it's done. And it's in various state of grime from what I've already been doing to a slightly different shade to not too much to the point of going to the point, as we go for a point, to an area which is severely saturated with grime. And we've got that on the area where I'm going to put a TTA wagon for the fueling point, as well as across here. This was an experiment, and I have to say it has come out exceptionally well now that we've sprayed it all with hairspray to lock it all in. The rails have been cleaned as well. Across the double slip, this has been my, well, not my nightmare, but my sort of do I do it or not. This actuator is rather stiff now, so I need to go in underneath to find out what's wrong. I think basically the paint's got in the mechanism and it's a bit tight, but never mind. And again, as you can see, try and get into focus. I think it's come out very, very well. Right, the mixture is Vallejo steel, which is quite a fine powder, and that is mixed with, like I say, with PECO coal dust and two colours of rusty rails tractor. I don't remember what they call it now. And I've also added just a little bit of Vallejo rust, which you can sometimes you can see the actual pigment where it's a bit thicker. I think that's an area there. But yeah, that's essentially what I've been doing the past few weeks. This has been a bit of a nightmare. This is, I think this is about the 8th attempt I've done this now. There was a distinctive bump on this section of rail, and basically I just took it all out. It was because of the fish plate. But what I've done now, getting to focus, is I've added just there, same there, on each side, some screws to support the rails. Now the idea was, is I was going to solder those on, but I've actually got the wrong screws in there. I actually thought they were brass, coated brass, but they're actually, I think they might be steel, stainless steel, so might have to unsolder everything again. Put some different screws in there, but anyway, this is all right now. There's very little in the way of bump, and that's essentially it, really. Zombies, can't remember if they appeared in the last video, but we've got some Backman Scene Craft permanent wave packs, bought all three of them off eBay. So we've got the three there, and then we come back over to. Over two here, and then the other ones are on the fueling point. Right, what's going to change? Obviously, we're still waiting for Railway Laser Lines to make his shed available. I also need to get the money together now to buy it, because I ended up, because I bought them spent the money buying those. But all the power at the moment for the buildings is run from a 12 volt power supply. And what I intend to do now, in fact I'm just waiting for them to arrive, is I've bought some train tech LED control boards, and they're DCC. They'll be wired directly into the layout to get away from having to use a 12 volt power supply. They should be here within the next week. And that would go in, sort them out, and quick scan, go all out of focus. The wagon repair shop also needs lighting. My original plan was, because just in under the centre of the roof, there's an area that could fit a strip light. Problem is basically because I've glued it all down now, it was a bit of a stupid idea, but there we are. So I'm not sure what to do with that internal lighting, but we'll figure it out eventually. And that's it. So enjoy your model making, wherever you are in the world. And we'll catch you in the next one. Bye now.